Hi, welcome viewers. Welcome to TEC. I'm Dr. Rajpal. And in the continuance of the book analysis series, I'm here with you with the third part of the book analysis series on Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. I believe that you must have enjoyed the previous videos. And now with the third part of Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. So we start our discussion with this subtitle, A 50 Cent Lessons in Persistence. And this is from the second chapter. The previous video was almost half portion on chapter two. So this is the scheme of things. We are going to take up the rest of the book in slides, maximum up to 6-7 slides. So that way we may divide the chapters into parts. So this story communicates the message that no does not necessarily mean no. For most of us, no means no. If somebody receives or gets a no to take to any project, we consider it as a final no. But this story will tell us that no does not necessarily mean no. So this is the secret of success. This is the secret of getting rich, that you don't see no as the final no. You put in your efforts to convert that no into a yes. Through this story, the author shares with us the secret of becoming the master of the situation. See the word, the key word here is the master of the situation. All of us have different life situations, and our power of persistence, our passion, and our commitment to live a happy or a better life is to give our best. And that's why we need to be the master of a situation. What is life as a whole? Life is an amalgamation of certain life situations put together, isn't it? So you need to be the master of a situation. And this chapter, through this chapter, Napoleon Hill shares with us the secret of becoming the master of situation through the power of persistence. So it is not only the key word, the master of the situation, but the methodology also, that how we can be the master of the situation. And it is through the power of persistence, the power of being committed. The incidents being narrated in this story takes place at the farm of Darby's uncle, where several sharecropper farmers lived. Quietly, the door was opened and the daughter of a tenant comes in. The uncle asked her roughly, "What do you want?" So the story takes place at the farm of Darby's uncle, and there are so many sharecropper farmers, those who live there, and the daughter of one of those tenant farmers comes, and the uncle roughly asks, "What do you want?" So the child meekly, the child politely, humbly replies, "My mom says to send her 50 cents. So maybe asking for the wages. So see how this mundane, normal story or incident of a place is converted into a kind of highly or overtly philosophical incident. We move on to the next video. The next slide. The uncle retorts, "I will not do it. Now you run on home." After some time, the uncle notices the girl standing at the same place. The uncle attempts to threaten the girl, but the girl steps forward and screams at the top of her voice, "My mom's gotta have that 50 cents. So the girl is quite assertive, though she was being asked to leave the place as Darby's uncle denied to pay the 50 cents. The uncle stops at her for a minute. Looks at her for a minute, puts hand in his pocket, takes out half a dollar and gives it to her. So the uncle, who was reluctant not to give her the 50 cents, finally succumbs to her and she emerges out as a winner. So here one is compelled to ponder over these questions. What do you make of this story? It's a very simple story. What do you make of it? And what strange power did that child use? The answer to these questions will be found in the principles described in this book. And this is not my promise. This is the promise of the author himself. So you can believe it. Next. The book will quicken your receptive powers. This is very important. Being receptive determines how well and how much we learn, whether it's language or knowledge pertaining to any discipline. The power of reception really determines our knowledge, really determines the kind of personality we become. The book will enable us to convert the defeats into stepping stones to opportunity. Next, the writer proposes 13 principles which work individually or together as catalysts. Reading these principles may be the catalyst that causes your answers to suddenly come to you as an idea, a plan, or a purpose. See, this is the beauty of this book, that how something is being introduced to you, that certain questions are being posed while narrating an incident, and then that answer, the answer to a certain question, may come to you as an idea or a plan, a complete plan maybe, or maybe a purpose for which you just being committedly, you put your 100%. These 13 principles contain the best and most practical ways and means of creating ideas. So this will help us in getting a sort of manual from this book that how we can create the ideas. Are you ready to quicken your receptive powers? I hope yes. And if yes, continue to watch this video and complete this book analysis series from first part to the last part. Success consciousness. This is the another sub theme or subtitle of chapter 2 itself. The writer opines that once riches begin to come, they come so quickly and in such a great abundance that you will wonder where they have been hiding during all those lean years. It is also a folk belief that, and when I quote a folk belief, let me quote it in its original language, ki jab bhagwan deta hai to chhappar phad ke deta hai. So this is the nature being observed by Napoleon Hill, sitting far away in the far lands, about riches. So this is the nature of riches. I recollected a kind of anecdote, and that is about deficit and Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth. So once there was a competition between the goddess Lakshmi and deficit, that is being known as Tota. So they caught a person, there was a debate basically between them, that who is superior or who is beautiful, who is beautiful, who looks beautiful. Exactly the word, the most exact translation is who looks beautiful. So they caught a simple guy like you and me, and they asked who looks beautiful. So the person was in a dilemma that if I call this deficit beautiful, so Lakshmi, goddess Lakshmi, goddess of wealth and prosperity, would be annoyed with me and she may make me a pauper. And if I call goddess Lakshmi beautiful, then this deficit, the tota, might be my worst enemy and can suck out my blood. So he finds in a dilemma, and then the man devises a way, and he asks both goddess Lakshmi and the deficit to show how they walk. So he asks them that you go up to that banyan tree and then come back. So they just moved in the direction of that banyan tree, and then they came back. And then the man very smartly replied that while going away, the deficit looks better or looks beautiful. And while coming closer, it's goddess Lakshmi who appears to be beautiful. So that's about the anecdote. Though it was not planned at all, but it came to my mind and I shared it with you in English translation. The author shares the secret of becoming rich by suggesting riches begin with a state of mind, with definiteness of purpose. Again, I'm repeating the idea, the definiteness of purpose. We need, as we discussed in the previous video, that thoughts are things, and they are powerful things when they are blended with, when they are mixed with definiteness of purpose, persistence, and the burning desire to convert those ideas, those thoughts, into material objects or riches. This is what we discussed yesterday. So the repetition or the continuance in the furtherance of that particular idea, riches begin with a state of mind. Everything begins with a state of mind, whether it is riches or any other thing, because ultimately the world around us, the world that we create, is a manifestation of our mind. Now the question that arises in one's mind is how to acquire the state of mind that will attract riches. Fine enough that poverty and riches, they are the product of human mind. But now the question arises, how to acquire such a mind that attracts riches? Napoleon Hill spent 25 years researching upon this question because he personally wanted to know that how people become wealthy. So how to develop a mind that attracts riches has been the sole target of finding an answer to this question, has been the sole target, sole research target of Napoleon Hill. And that's why we have taken up this book. So in the third part on third part in this book analysis series, once again, the idea is being repeated that this book is a product of someone's 25 years of rigorous research. So that much of concentration and sort of intelligence is required on the part of we, the readers, to make the most of it. So the author asserts, it is written assets, I'm sorry. The author asserts that by applying these principles, you can improve your financial statuses. So if you want to improve your financial status, you can apply the principles, the 13 principles and more. Next. Average people suffer from following two weaknesses to a larger extent. And these are, they're too much familiarity with the word impossible. Whenever we are in a situation, when somebody tries to motivate us that you can become this, you can earn this much or that much. So the first word that we utter is impossible, because that is beyond our capacity, our mental capacity to comprehend. And therefore we call it impossible. The habit of the second weakness of average people is the habit of measuring everything and everyone by your own impressions and beliefs. We are too much judgmental. We watch a video, before watching the entire video, or maybe before watching all the videos of our YouTube channel, we have practically seen people subscribing a channel and then unsubscribing it, because they have lost the sustained attention and power of concentration. Power of consciousness can at best be acquired once we have this sustained attention. Having enumerated these weaknesses of the average people, Hill expresses his doubt that some of the readers reading this book will have trouble believing that they can think and grow rich. So he takes a jibe at the readers that there are certain readers who might be doubting themselves that can they think and grow rich? Impossible, because we are too much familiar with the word impossible. So this over familiarity with the word impossible is one of our weaknesses. It hinders our path of success and prosperity. He doubts so because our thought habits, the habits in which our thoughts operate or our thoughts are formed. So our thought habits have been rooted in poverty, misery, failure, and defeat. And that's why we are not able to come terms to term with these promising opportunities of becoming rich or successful in life. Now, the pertinent questions: do you suffer from the weaknesses, either of the two, or both? Do you believe that you can think and become rich? Yes, you must believe that you can think and become rich, or you must believe that you can think and become what you want, because you have the power of persistence. You have the power to lend some sort of definitiveness to your idea, to your aim, to your intention, and that way you can achieve what you want. Next, remember, success comes to those who become success conscious. Failure comes to those who allow themselves to become failure conscious. Ask yourself, are you success conscious or failure conscious? You have to decide at your own. Answer to yourself and be honest to yourself. This is the best way to work upon yourself. There is no dearth of, say, the content or the material, but ultimately you need to identify the best material for you, the best platform to you, and then even subscribing to the best will not help you. Ultimately, the thing that will help you will be your own conscious efforts to identify yourself, to know yourself in a better way, and then to work upon the steps to improve your personality. Why does one read this book? This is the question. Or a question on the similar pattern: why does one watch these videos? The chief objective behind the writing of this book is to help you to learn the art of changing your mind from failure consciousness to success consciousness. And these videos are the attempt to simplify it one step ahead and to introduce to you these wonderful insights of Napoleon Hill. The final slide. The impossible Ford V8 motor. So in this slide, or now we are going to talk about Henry Ford, a big name. When Henry Ford decided to produce his famous V8 motor, he chose to build an engine with the entire 8 cylinders cast in one block. See, in those times, his imagination. The engineers denied the possibility of having such an engine. But Ford stood firm in his faith and desire and commitment. The engineers tried for 6 months, but to no avail. Ford commanded, "Stay on the job until you succeed, no matter how much time is required." So the technical people, the engineers denied the possibility, but Ford stood firm that it must be done. Finally, Ford determination won once again. It happened so because Ford knew the secret of success: knowing clearly what you want. Another secret of getting rich, or another secret of getting success: you know exactly what you want. The problem with us is we don't know what we exactly want. I want to be successful. What is your definition of success? This or that. We are never precise about what we want finally from us or from the life. Do you know what do you want exactly in your life? If no, think over it and try to get to know what you want to exactly, what you want to have in your life exactly. Because until or unless you know it, you cannot achieve it. So I leave the reflection part to you, and I hope you must have enjoyed this video as well. We are trying our level the best to cover up this book analysis series soon, so that we may take up another books. But at the same time, we are also not in such a haste to complete this book without doing justice to it. My commitment to myself is to give you the best out of this book, and I would be doing justice to each and every single word of this text. If you have liked the video, kindly like it. First of all, thanks. Like it, share it, and if you have not subscribed the channel, kindly do subscribe it. Thank you so much. Have a nice time.